In this video, we'll be evaluating trigonometric expressions involving both trig functions and inverse trig functions. And for these examples, the inner function will be the trig function, and the outer function will be the inverse trig function. So for the first example, we have inverse sine of sine pi over 3. Let's start by modeling the sine of pi over 3 with a reference triangle on the coordinate plane. Pi over 3 is equal to 60 degrees. So we'll sketch a 60 degree reference angle and reference triangle in the first quadrant. So we know the short leg is 1, the hypotenuse is 2, and the longer leg is square root 3. And this is pi over 3 radians. So the sine of pi over 3 is equal to square root 3 over 2. So we have inverse sine of square root 3 over 2. And now we know that the inverse sine function returns an angle theta, where theta must be on the closed interval from negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2. Well, the angle in this interval that has a sine function value of square root 3 over 2 is just pi over 3, the angle that we just modeled. So you might be asking, why go through all of this when we know that inverse sine and sine are inverse to one another and therefore undo each other? While that is true, sometimes it's not quite as straightforward as this first example. Let's take a look at our second example. We have inverse sine of cosine negative 3 pi over 4. Let's go ahead and sketch this angle, negative 3 pi over 4. We'll have a clockwise rotation of 135 degrees, so it's going to look something like this. So our reference triangle would be here. So if this is negative 135 or negative 3 pi over 4, this angle here would be 45 degrees or pi over 4. Let's go ahead and label it as 45 degrees. So this is a 45, 45, 90 reference triangle. So we'd have negative 1, negative 1, and square root 2. So the cosine of negative 3 pi over 4 is going to be the ratio of the adjacent side to the hypotenuse, or negative 1 over square root 2. So this simplifies to inverse sine of negative 1 over square root 2. So now we need an angle that has a sine function value of negative 1 divided by square root 2, but this angle theta does need to be on the closed interval from negative pi over 2 to pi over 2. Because there are an infinite number of angles that have a sine function value of negative 1 divided by square root 2, so there's a restriction on the output or the range of inverse sine. So the angle that's modeled here is not the angle that we can use to determine what theta should be. Theta has to be from 0 to pi over 2 radians, or from 0 to negative pi over 2 radians. And since the sine function value is negative, we're going to have to sketch a 45, 45, 90 reference angle in the fourth quadrant, not the third. So it would have to look something like this. Notice how the y coordinate would still be negative 1. The x coordinate's not involved in the sine function. My hypotenuse is square root 2. So this angle here is the angle we're looking for on this interval, so it's going to be negative 45 degrees or negative pi over 4 radians. And this is what I mean by they're not all quite as straightforward as this first example. Let's go and take a look at one more of these. Here we have inverse tangent sine negative pi over 6. So again, we'll start with the innermost function. We're going to go ahead and sketch the reference triangle for sine negative pi over 6. Pi over 6 is 30 degrees, so we're going to sketch negative 30 degrees in standard position, something like this. So here's our reference triangle to help us evaluate sine negative pi over 6. So we'd have negative 1 to square root 3. So the sine of negative pi over 6 is going to be the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse, so this is going to be negative 1 half. So now we have inverse tangent of negative 1 half. An inverse tangent returns an angle theta on the open interval from negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2. And again, this is not the angle we're looking for, so let's go ahead and clear this. Because the tangent function value is negative, we'll have to sketch a reference triangle in the fourth quadrant that has a tangent function value of negative 1 divided by 2. So if this is our angle theta, the opposite side would be negative 1, the adjacent side would be positive 2, and we don't know the hypotenuse, but we don't really need it. Now this is not one of those nice reference triangles, because the 2 is not the hypotenuse, it's the adjacent side. So we're actually going to have to use our calculator to get a decimal approximation of this angle, keeping in mind that it's going to be a negative angle, so we're looking for an angle that rotates from here to here. It doesn't say whether to express this in degrees or radians. Let's just make sure we know what mode we're in. Right now we're in degree mode. Let's go ahead and leave it in degree mode for a minute. So we're going to press secant tangent negative 1/2, or negative 1 divided by 2. So our angle is approximately negative 26.6 degrees. Let's also get the measure in radian mode. So we'll just go ahead and change the mode. And we'll type in secant tangent negative 1 divided by 2 again, so that we have both measures. So theta can also be expressed in radians as approximately negative 0.46 radians. So this will be approximately negative 26.6 degrees, which is approximately equal to negative 0.46 radians. I hope you found these examples helpful.